Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the DateTime axis in the .NET MAUI Cartesian Charts control. I will demonstrate how to add a DateTime axis to the Cartesian charts and customize its interval and interval type. I'll also show you how to modify the axis range and apply range padding. Finally, I'll show how to invert and hide an axis. This line chart presents a visual representation of the highest sales date and amount for each month. As you can see, DateTime values can be displayed for each data point in the chart using the DateTime axis on the horizontal axis. First, I open an existing MAUI application where I have already configured the necessary chart namespace and added the MAUI Cartesian chart control. If you want to learn how to add the .NET MAUI Cartesian chart to an app, I recommend watching the Getting Started video linked in the card. You can also download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description below. To initialize the axis for the chart, you need to define the x-axis and y-axis collections. In this case, I want to bind a data source with two fields, date and sales amount. So, I'll add a DateTime axis to plot the DateTime values on the x-axis. In the y-axis collection, I'll add a numerical axis to plot the numerical values on the y-axis. Additionally, set the main title for the chart to highest sales of 2021 and 2022. Now, let me proceed with populating data to visualize the highest sales date and amount using the line series. First, I create a new class named Model to represent sales details. Once created, make this class public. Within this class, I define two properties, date and sales amount. To generate the sales data, create another class named ViewModel and make it public. Within this class, define a new property named data that will hold a list of sales details. Then, initialize the constructor and assign a list of sales details to the data property. To render the series, navigate to the main page XAML file and set the view model as the binding context for the content page. This allows the data to be accessible in XAML. To visualize data, add a line series to the chart and set its item source property to data. Additionally, map the data source fields, date to X binding path and sales amount to Y binding path. To enable the data label, set show data labels to true. As you can see, the line series chart is rendered with date time values displayed on the horizontal axis with the main title, highest sales of 2021 and 2022. Now, let me show you how to set a title for the chart axis. Add the title property for DateTime axis and define the chart axis title element. Inside this element, add the text property and set x-axis title to month. Similarly, I'll add a title for the numerical axis. By setting these titles, the chart becomes easier to understand, as they provide clear labels and context for the information being conveyed. Next, let's explore how to change the axis interval and interval type. By default, the interval between the DateTime axis labels is calculated automatically using the minimum and maximum values of the provided data. However, if you want to customize the interval in the x-axis, define the interval property and set an appropriate value, such as 2. You can observe that the interval between the labels is customized. By default, the DateTime interval type is determined automatically based on the data range in the DateTime axis. There are various interval types available for the DateTime axis, including auto, days, months, and more. However, if you want to change the interval type to days, you can set the interval type property to days. For this demonstration, I'll set the interval to 10. You will notice that the interval type is customized to display labels every 10 days. Next, let's explore how to customize the axis range.
For instance, if you want to show the axis range from October 1, 2021, to May 1, 2022 on x-axis, set its minimum property to October 1, 2021.
And maximum property to May 1, 2022. Before running the application, remove the interval and interval type properties.
You'll notice that the axis range is customized, allowing you to focus on specific data ranges within the chart. Next, let me demonstrate how to apply range padding to the date-time axis. Range padding means applying padding to the minimum and maximum extremes of the axis. Before starting, remove the minimum and maximum properties. There are many types of range padding available, such as additional, auto, none, and more. If you would like to learn more about the different types of range padding and their usage, I recommend referring to the documentation provided at the link below. To add padding to both the start and end of the axis range, define the range padding property
and set it to additional.
Looking here, the axis range is extended with additional padding at both ends. If you want the visible start and end range to round to the nearest interval value, you can set the range padding property to round. See, the start and end range is rounded to the nearest interval value.
Next, I will show you how to inverse and hide the date-time axis. First, remove the range padding property. To inverse the date-time axis, define the isInversed property and set it to true.
Notice that the date-time axis is inverted, resulting in the points being rendered from right to left.
Suppose I want to hide the date-time axis, then just set its isVisible property to false. You can see that the horizontal axis is no longer displayed in the chart.
In this video, I have shown you how to add a date-time axis to the Cartesian chart and customize its interval and interval type. I also showed how to modify the axis range, apply range padding, and how to inverse and hide an axis. If you want to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this.
Thanks for watching.